with my stations, I have teachers. My teachers are my students. They lead the group. They are teaching each student on a specific skill. And those skills are picked by the students. The students know, hey, this is what we've done for the last 4 weeks. This is what I don't understand. This is what I need more help in. And so I find those skills and we practice on those in our group. And then the teacher is a student who feels confident and they have all those skills and they're ready to help their classmates. Yes. My accountable talk is that when you're in your groups, you have to use accountable talk. You can't just say, no, that's not right. You have to say, I disagree with you because, and state why you disagree. If you agree with them, you can't just say, okay, that's a great answer. I agree, I got that too. No, you have to explain why you did it. And a big thing with the accountable talk is there's more than one way to solve a problem. And all of my students, you know, if they use this technique to solve it, then I want them to explain it. Because there may be a student in their group that didn't really understand it, but once they've all explained it, their ways, and they're all not the same way, then that student is able to learn from those other students. So using accountable talk is huge for students. They need to understand what accountable talk is and what it looks like. And, you know, like example, can you explain it to me in a different way? So then another student would say, yes, I did it differently than they did, so maybe you can understand it my way. And so they just use that as they get through the problems and work and try to conclude and get an answer. At the end of the day, what they said mattered. They were confident enough to get up and do the work, and then, you know, we would disagree with them and we would teach them how to get there. And that it's a process. It doesn't happen overnight, but you just have to keep working with the students and you have to build those students up. You have to know your students. You have to know what their personality is, what they need to be successful, what their home life is like. You have to be more involved than just a classroom teacher. You have to go to ball games. You have to know what's important to them and you relate that to them. And then once they feel safe, they'll do anything for you.
What about this group over here? What do you think our next step should be for you? Yes, you're great. What do you think your next step should be? So now you